Dude!
I called the tongue!
That is not a tongue! I'm not teaching you how to play with tongues! Whereas if you said, dude, I was a little, I was too much desperate on playing in tongues. To the extent, yes, I was anticipating to fake my tongues by playing in Lingala here in Pulpit. So I thought that if I play in Lingala, I'm going to be confused that Tony is playing in tongues. Bonus if you said, by the damn God, the God is merciful and gracious. This is the new day that the Lord has made. We have to rejoice and be glad in
it.
Bonus if you said. You have a reason to rejoice. Tell your neighbor, you have a reason to rejoice.
You have a reason to rejoice.
Yes, today I want to preach about compassion. What is compassion? Compassion is a noun. Isn't it?
Yes.
Compassion means deep awareness of the suffering of another. Not just awareness, but deep awareness of the suffering of another. Yeah? With the intention to relieve it. You know, you are aware, yes, you are aware to the deepest level of the suffering of another. Yes, with a wish to relieve that person from that suffering and pain. Wonders if you
Amen.
So every human being is compassionable. Yes, you need to be compassionate to others. Bonus if you were Sarah.
Maybe.
Yes, you need to understand people. Yes, compassionate is a synonym. Synonyms are made different names but means the same thing. Yes, something like empathy, having empathy, having pity. Yes? Towards someone. Yes. Having tender-heartedness. Yes. Being sorrowful, kindness, heartily, being heartily to people suffering. Being merciful. Yeah? All these are synonyms to this great word called compassion. Yes. You need to be compassionable. You need to be compassionate to people. Yes. Because we are compassionately made by our compassionable God. Bonus if you son. Yes, because if you have compassion, you will not be in a position to judge people. You will not be in a position to condemn people. You will not be in a position to sideline people. You will not be in a position to respond to evil with evil. Why? Because you understand them. Bwana Mungu, nashangaa kabisa, nifike jinsi ulivyo. Yangu na ifuingi any vain imagination that will raise itself against the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Oh, Jehovah Lord, if there is any spirit that may dare try to raise itself against the knowledge and wisdom of Jesus Christ, I put it a halt in Jesus' name. Oh, may you make our minds, our hearts receptive to your word, so that your spirit may digest it in our future benefit. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are great, you are awesome, Jehovah Lord. Thank you, Father, because you are making a way. You are making a way. Oh, dear Lord, you are great. I worship you, I adore you. Be magnified and be glorified. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you are great. I worship you, I adore you. If there is any spirit of confusion, I put it a halt in Jesus' name. Oh, if there is any spirit of grudges and hatred, conspiracy and gossip, I put it a halt in Jesus' name. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you are making a way. Make a way in our hearts. Make a way in our hearts. Make a way in our hearts. In Jesus' name, let's say that we say better or so for no man as it is with us, like a rush. worship win. You are going to see his salvation in Jesus' name. Ale passe de coloto rosse de kese de sobalasse de tese. Ale barapa doso bateso boco losse de torose. Ale passo boto rosse de kese de toroso balese. Oh, the Lord is saying that the prayers and the prophecies that are passing today, and the past, present, and future, they are not in vain. They must come to pass, whether you like it or not, whether you speak against it or not, whether you waited to the extent of giving up or not. He is coming. He is our Lord. He is the Lord who provides. He is the Lord Adonai, our divine master. He is with us. No one is going to die prematurely. No one is going to die sickling. No one is going to reject it completely. The Lord is connecting us and reconnecting us to his grace. But the Lord is asking us to prepare ourselves to go back to Shiloh, the original place of worship. Oh, don't give up. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. You will never be striken by the sun during the day and the moon during the night, because he is your protector. He is your protector. He is your deliverer. He who is in you is never he who is in the world. Oh, don't give up. Don't give up in your life. Don't give up in your career, in your gift, in your talent, in your emotions, in your relationships. The Lord is with you. 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 May you receive his blessings. May you receive his power. May you receive his healing. May you receive his abundance. May you receive his grace. May you receive his mercy. Oh, may the Lord cut off the spirit of magic, the spirit of ancestral curses, the spirit of ancestral yokes, proclivities and captivities. May they be lifted from your life. I want us to welcome God in our hearts once again. We want to tell him to refresh our spirits. We want to tell him to refresh our souls.
Oh,
Baba, come.
Oh,
come.
Oh, come.
Oh,
come.
Come.
Come and pray.
Oh,
Tawala. Oh, Tawala. Tawalika. Tawala.
May the Lord reign your church. May the Lord reign your family. May the Lord reign everything that's allowed to be. Oh, yes, yes, yes. The Spirit of God is moving amid this earth in a mighty way.
Oh,
yes, yes. I can feel the Spirit of God. I can feel the power of God moving with us.
Amen. Oh,
compassion. Yes, compassion is understanding some people, understanding your neighbor, understanding your parents, your children. There is no way you can give someone direction. There is no way you can advise someone to follow the right path in life without understanding him. Why? Because if you do that, you will be misleading that person. Yes, you have to wear his shoes so that you know, you may know where it pinches. A white man said that it is the wearer of the shoe that knows where it pinches. Sometimes we dare try to influence people's life. Yes, without understanding them first. Yes, it can be your son, it can be your daughter, it can be your wife, it can be your husband, your relative, or the person whom you are under custodian to. Yes, you may try to give that person direction out of your own will, out of your own thoughts, without understanding that person. When you do so, you are misleading that person. can't understand someone without his consent. Sometimes it's good to listen. Sometimes it's good to listen to your child. Sometimes it's good to listen to your wife, your husband, so that you understand that person. The Bible says that in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth, and he created everything in the span of 5 days, and said that it is good. But he looked around and said that I'm lonely still, and make me a man. And he made a man, and he commanded a man not to touch the forbidden fruit. But the Lord didn't understand that man very well, because God is a spirit and man is a flesh. So it reached a point that man misbehaved and decided to go his ways and touch the forbidden fruit. And the Lord cast him, and the Lord rejected him. But the Lord, who is full of compassion, he wanted to understand this man further. And what the Lord did, yes, even though he chased them out of the Garden of Eden, yes, he showed compassion unto them, yes, and made them clothed made of tanning of skins. Then after that, the Lord said to himself that I have not understood that man very well. Yet I have to come back on earth and be as this man so that I may understand him very well. Wow, the Bible says in one of the famous verses in the Bible, somewhere in the book of John chapter 3 verse 16, and the Lord so loved the world. Yes, he created the world, but he didn't understood that world very well, because he was a spirit and the world was physical. So he said that now that I love the world so much, yes, I want to send my only begotten son. Yes, the Lord was doing this with compassion, because love without compassion is dead. So the Lord said that I will send me myself to the race of the men. And he came in the form of Jehovah Emmanuel, who is Jesus Christ, so that he may understand the trials and tribulations of the sons of men, of the physical world. And Jesus Christ walked like men, behaved like men, because he was 100% man and 100% God. There is no way you can understand that person if you not be in a position to wear his shoes. There is no way you can understand that bishop. There is no way you can understand that pastor if you are not aware of what he is passing through. Until he gives you some part of his life. Yes, until he tells you, come and wear my shoes. Come and live with my wife. Come and live with my children, so that you may understand the pain and the goodness that I'm enjoying in this marriage, that I'm enjoying in this life. Am I making sense to someone today? That's why someone sang a song entitled, Bolingo Langa Na Yesu. Yeah? My love with Christ. Bolingo Na Yo. Tell your neighbor, Bolingo Na Yo.
Bolingo Na Yo.
What is so funny there? You know, you are amazed, yeah? And that is not tongues, yeah? That is Lingala, yeah? You know, I'm a Lingala guy trapped in a Kenyan body. So let me tell you. So the Lord decided to wear our shoe so that he knows where it pinches. Wow. Yes, he decided to come down on earth and wear our shoes. Yes, it is a point that he was a hustler, he was a sufferer somewhere in someone's carpenter's shop. Yes, imagine. Yes, he was a carpenter for 30 good years. Yes, working as a sufferer. Yes, working under someone's authority. He was working in his own family workshop. Imagine, yes, Sam is working in Lucas' workshop. Sometimes Lucas has a brother who leave, isn't he? Where you got my son? I feed him when he got in. Luca, name shout amen.
Amen.
Wow, God is great. So let me tell you. Yes, he decided to work, to walk like men, behave like men, hustle like men, rejected like men, yes, trampled in the ground, yes, and that's why I normally tell you people, there is no way you can be a minister of the word of God without a wilderness. Your wilderness is your rejection. Your wilderness is your lack. Your wilderness is your disappointment. That does not mean that the Lord has rejected you. That means that the Lord is making you. You are a king in the making. Am I making sense to someone today? Yes, you need to be gossiped, you need to be bewitched, you need to be despised, you need to be trampled, you need to be sickling, you need to be a sufferer for you to be a king. The Bible says, as he was living, he was tormented, he was stripped was minted, his name was flashed off from the registry of the registrar. Why? Because he was just a useless kind of a person. People thought that he was useless. People thought that he was a blasphemer. Yes, he was impacted all forms of evil, but he stood firm. Yes, it reached a point that even thought that the Lord had rejected him by saying that, my God, why have you rejected him? That was not the spiritual Christ that was speaking, but the physical Christ that was speaking. There are some times that you may think that the Lord has rejected you. There is a time that you may think that your prayers, your fasting, and your giving are in vain because you have waited for too long. But I'm telling you, your prayers, your prophecies, your visions, and your aspirations are never neglected and can never be neglected in any way, because the Lord that we serve is full of compassion. The book of Matthew, chapter 9, verse 36. The Bible says, but when he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them. Yes, but when he saw the multitudes, yes, it means that he saw, a multitude means a group of people. Yes, and according to group psychology, the science that is involved in group psychology, it is said that when you see a group of people together, yes, you may not find these people operating in unison. Yes, you will see, you will discover that there are some stereotypical behaviors in them. Yes, because in group of people you find witches, you will find magicians, you will find haters. In a group of people there is gossip, where a group of people is there are sufferers, there are successful men, there are people who are suffering from superiority complex, and those who are suffering from inferiority complex, there are those who are healthy, and those who are... So in this group of multitude, yes, Christ didn't segregate them. He didn't judge them. He knew that there are thieves in this multitude. He knew that there are sorcerers in this multitude. That people were following me because of bread. That people were following me because of fish. But I am moving close unto them with compassion. A time has come that you have to move close unto the people with compassion. Yes, I know you are a gossiper. I know you are a conspirator. I know you are a hypocrite. But I don't hate you because of that. I'll move close unto you with compassion. I know you are bewitching me, but I'm moving close unto you with compassion. Judas, I know that one day you'll betray me, but I'm moving close unto you with compassion. Peter, I know that you deny me not once, not twice, but thrice, but I'm moving close to you with compassion. Where are the compassionate believers amidst us today? Sometimes we hate people so much, sometimes we judge them so much by what they do, by how they behave. Sometimes we sideline them because they messed us up in our past to the extent of neglecting the gifts or the things that the Lord has given you to help that sister, to help that brother. If you do that, you're not failing that person, but you're failing God. And the Bible says that cursed is he who do the work of God in slumber. Alaniwaye mtu yule afanyaye kazi ya Mungu kwa kulikuwa. There is no way you can be a minister of the word without compassion. Yes, without the eyes of compassion. Yes, I'm seeing this man is a liar, but I'm moving closer to him. Why? Because I know that that liar is a spirit, and it has no power over the power that I'm operating in. Yes, I know that you're a witch, but I'm coming in your house, and I will eat therein, because I know that your magic can do me nothing. In fact, he who is in me will destroy that magic. If you fail to move close to people with compassion, I'm telling you, there is no way you can save those souls. There is no way you can direct those souls. That's why you need to be a worryless. You know, you know why Christ moved people with compassion? Because God is love. Yes, and love can never be experienced. Love can never be exercised without compassion. You need to be compassionate for your love to be seen, for your love to be experienced, and for your love to be embraced. A love that will change their hearts. A love that will make their crooked ways straight. A love that will make your conspirer, that person who is gossiping against you, yes, look unto you with shyness. With inferiority kind of look. Yes, because yes, they are gossiping you, but you are loving them. They are stoning you to death, but you are telling God, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. Yes, these people are great men. They are soldiers. They are not just ordinary soldiers. They are not Panyako soldiers. Yes, they are not Askari Rungus. Yes, they are soldiers who are trained by the government. They are mature people, but they are stoning me to death, knowing very well that I'm innocent, but I'm not repaying evil with evil. I'm repaying evil with good. Forgive them, Father, for they don't know what they're doing. This person is gossiping me. He knows very well that gossip is sin. This person is despising me. He knows very well that despise is sin. But I'm moving close to that person with compassion. By doing that, you will win that person's soul back and will cover the multitude of sin and will receive the crown of life. Well, think about it. Think about it. May someone think about it. May you shout, think about it. Think about it. Think about it. You need to move close unto the people you hang around with compassion. Yes, you don't tell that person, yes, I'm a prophet. I saw you are gossiping me somewhere. I saw that you don't like me. I know that you're avoiding. No, you don't have to do that. No matter how many times you see these visions and revelations, you have to move closer to those people with compassion. Because when you turn that person's heart, that person will remember you for his lifetime because you have changed him. No one is perfect. No one is righteous. That person who is around, who is close to you, needs your help for him to be righteous, for him to walk in the life of Christ. He needs you. He needs your compassionate power so that he may reform and transform. The Bible says, and there was a man who was beaten up, yeah, to the extent of experiencing near-death experience, yes. And there was a person who passed through that, there was a Jew, yes, who passed by that road. And so that person said, yes, I'm well-dressed. Yes, I have that superior kind of self-esteem. There is no way I can attend to that man. He passed away. And there came a priest, yes, who was well-dressed in a priest-like regalia. Yes, he passed by that place and saw that man and said, there is no way I can attend to that man because he will dirtify me. So he passed by, and there was a Samaritan, a person whom people judge, a person whom people looked as a failure, a person whom people say that this man does not know God, this man does not go to church. Yes, he passed by the same route and saw that man who was beaten up. And the Bible says, he moved close to that person with compassion. I don't know this person, but I feel the pain that this person is feeling. Why? Because maybe I passed through what this person is passing through at this time. There's no way you can understand that person who is rejected without passing rejection. There's no way you can understand that person who is lacking without passing that part of lack. There is no way you can understand that person who is passing the moment of disappointment if you have never passed through that path. You have to pass through that. The Bible says that even though I shall pass through the valley of shadow of death, yes, it doesn't say that, Lord, make me pass out of those valleys of shadows of death. I want to pass through the golden gates in heaven. No, before you pass through the golden gates in heaven, it takes the valley of shadow of death. And in the valley of shadows of death, there is no direction, there is no compass, there is no trafficable route that will pass comfortably. Because there is mayhem, there are animals, there are spiders in valleys of death. There is too much snake, too much monkeys, too much dreadful animals there. Yes, but I'm passing through that place. I know that I will see through the scorpions that are there and serpents, but they can do me no harm because it's just a pass away of experiencing me to minister one day as an experienced minister of the word of God, as a minister who will understand people who making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Hey, Bolingo Nayo, I love you all. Bolingo Nayo Nyoso, I love you all. Yeah? Bwana asifiwe sana. That's why when someone hates me, when someone gossips me, yes, I don't bow down to that hatred. I don't bow down to gossip because I'm too big for that. Yes, you can gossip me the way you want. You can judge me the way you can point fingers unto me as many times as you want. But I will not respond unto it because I'm Mr. Holiness. Because what I passed through, I'm telling you, is hell in a cell. So your disgrace, your judgment is nothing to me. Why? Because I believe that despite what you are doing unto me, I'm more than a conqueror. You are more than a conqueror. Amen. Don't respond to mosquito bites with hammers. A time has come that you have to walk tall, you have to talk tall, and you have to tip tall because you're the son of the Most High God. Akisengenya, kusisengenya. And that person is flamboyant. So I look at one, he says, oh, my God, why are you jumping with your flamboyant body in front of Pastor Tony? You are defying his eyes. But then I say that I will never, I make a covenant with my eyes that I love. Okay. What else if you were sorry?
Amen.
Akisengenya, mpende, adui, mpende, isn't it? Yeah, love that person. When that person appoints you, move close unto him, running, telling him, I love you, nakupenda, nipende. Hey, God is real. God is love. He moved close unto the multitude with compassion. Am I making sense to someone today? You know, I was talking to someone some days in my group, in my WhatsApp group, in our WhatsApp group, not mine, but our WhatsApp group. Yes, I was telling them about the issues of life. You know, life is divided into three. The issues of life come from your soul, from your heart. And these issues of life are divided into three. Yes, and it starts with, I was saying that out of your heart, I think the book of Proverbs chapter 7 somewhere, yeah? Yes, out of your heart comes issues of life. You know, issues of life are divided into three. First, there are physical issues. Isn't it? Physical issues that must be addressed physically. That's why the Bible says somewhere that, and the Lord said, come and let us reason together. They take reason. Because the Lord in heaven respects your reason. Yeah, the Lord some days in the book of Genesis came down and scrutinize the reason of the sons of men and saw that it is continually evil, and he judged them as per their wickedness and evilness of their heart. So there are physical issues that must be addressed and attended to physically, like taking a shower. Yes, you need to take a shower. You don't need to pray, God, wash me with your blood. I love not when you're like this, I don't get a shower. You stink, and people will reject you. You stink, and people will reject you. Isn't it? Yeah? What a spirit, sir. Yeah? You don't have to say that you are a man looking for a lady to get to marry, but you are dressed code, the way you look very flamboyant. You look very pathetic, not flamboyant, but pathetic. Yeah? You don't, your dental hygiene is poor, yes, your dress code is pathetic, and you're telling God that, hey, I need to get a beautiful lady to get married to. No, it is impossible. I don't say, like, what I'm saying, ish, what the hell? Isn't it? Hey, if you're a lady, there is no way you can get married if you despise men. Hey, sweetheart, you look great. And where did you get the confidence of telling me that? Hmm? You know, you will waste yourself. Isn't it? So you have to know how to deal with things. You have to know how to deal with issues physically. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Yes, if you are a lady, you have to know how to keep a man around you. If you are a man, you have to know how to attract an opposite sex for you to get married. Isn't it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, there was a lady that I met somewhere. Yeah, that lady was fasting for 40 good days. Yeah, she was fasting so that the Lord may give her a husband to marry her. Hey, that lady, I looked at that lady. That lady was pathetic. Yes, her best, yes, her appearance, her skin was pale. So I asked that lady, what are you doing? I am fasting 40 days for God to give me a man. I've never met a serious man in my life. And what that lady has said, this lady, you are told, this is called spirit of confusion. So if you fast for 40 days, for you to get a husband, to marry you, how will you look like? That lady was pathetic, yeah? Her appearance was just pathetic. Who can be attracted unto you the way you look? Who told you that you can fast for 40 days and you will get married? You'll spend your money for nothing. What has you is happening? Yes, all men like ladies who has Coca-Cola face, and they are not Coca-Cola face, but a Fanta face, and a Coca-Cola kind of body, isn't it? Yeah? Yes, you have to be attractive, isn't it? But if you fast for 40 days for you to get married, what are you doing? You destroy your beauty for nothing, in vain. Yes, for you to get married, I advise that lady, for you to get married, you have to go back in shape, you have to eat very well, you have to take some supplement of vitamins so that you present yourself in a high-class manner for you to get a high-class man that will suit your whims. He said, use wisdom, that is a natural knowledge that needs to be applied in natural issues. Am I making sense? Am I making sense to someone today? Yes. For example, I'm a pastor. Nimekujiyatwa kwa ubiria. Nimeva viatu za Reebok. Za white. Nimeva long ya red. Nimeva shati ya green. Na imeenda, kola imeenda. Yata mtasikia injini yangu kweli. But if this God, if this is confusion, this is not God. Yeah? Yes, I have to walk myself into Sir Henry. Sata kama sinapeta ni ambia muhindi. Hey, wepatia nini hiyo? So that this mama, you see God in me. Yeah? Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
These are physical issues that must be addressed physically. And I think kuna kitu inaitwa spiritual issues. Spiritual issues are the things that are addressed through in prayers and fasting. Isn't it? Through Jehovah Adonai, the Lord our Master. So that's when you have to fast and pray, because I want to see revelations. And when you are saved, you are a conqueror. And that's why some churches are not believing in salvation. They say that Jesus Christ already saved them. Hey, it is true, it's biblical. Hey, Jesus Christ saved us, isn't it? So these are the issues that need prayer and fasting under the direction of the Holy Spirit. Like, for example, yes, I need to see that revelation. I need to be used to the higher level in spiritual matters. Yes, I need to see myself advancing higher and higher. Yes, you need to fast and pray about it. The Bible says that some may not come out unless you fast and pray. These are spiritual issues. After that, there are family issues. Family issues are ancestral issues. The passage that the Lord said that I will visit their iniquities upon their children to their children. For example, HIV is in your family. Yes, it's attacking your family. Maybe your family has people who died out of their mind, who are bonkers. Yeah? They died in their bonkers condition. Yes, these are the issues. If they are in your family, these are family issues. And family issues are broken through altars by giving. Isn't it? Yeah, that's why Christ came, so that he may get rid of sacrifices that Moses commanded in the Old Testament. But he did condemn giving. These are altars that are broken by giving. Maybe people used to die in your family without getting married. Yeah, these are issues that must be broken by giving. So you need to be a balanced diet believer. When you fast, when you pray, and then you give. Am I making sense?
Yes.
So, siyate kuomba hapa, tipei, miss your gang, alafu na expect that Mungu anibariki nipwe smile. It will never happen. Yeah? We will be like Lazarus, going into a Mungu lakini uko na kidonda. Isn't it? Bona asifiwe sana. That national issue, the natural issues, spiritual issues, and family issues. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes,
I was there was a day, last Sunday I was somewhere in a conference, when I was in our Facebook, that conference that I was in. Yes, I was with very great men of God there, from Ghana, from Canada, and Ghana. So, after to go to my car somewhere, in the church, a pulpit, and after I end up, wachungaji unajua wapati wanda high table, isn't it? He said that wachungaji wakikula kupu, wachitika wakule kideri, ya? Kwa hivyo kikenda kukinifoda pia unataka wakula kupu la kini. So what? Kwa hivyo kwa away from him, you work out of iniquity. Mwana hivyo. Pana ukiona na ichwa naenda kwa wenda hiyo kanisa na kuwa hei mchungaji enda mbele. Mina enda nikiimba nema ya mwana. Kani chosha. Ya wana sima hei, pia mimi nema ya. Kwa hei. badass if you were sad. So in that conference, once, let me tell you, I was sharing with my brother in the morning in my house, to go to Wasani, our international, our local musicians for Kenya. So Wasani, what are you going to do? You are going to go to the hospital. You are going to go to the hospital. You are one of my best, Erasto Shengezi is a very good friend of mine. They come, Erasto! Hebu niambie nishike picha. Akaanza, usini cheke ndugu, mwela pezo. I lifted my hands, so I said, ooh, wonderful. Then at the end of the day, Erasto akamua kuja ukule na washimu. Kwa hivyo mwambia, nikawambia, mimi malinaenda, I want to go with Erasto, because I like this man so much. I don't know what I'm saying. There are natural, spiritual, and family issues, isn't it? Senior, maybe people have issues, these issues, not maybe a rational come out of it through the word and knowledge of Jesus Christ. But this person and operate, yes, but in a curse, this person is a curse. That's why you can never compare your glory with someone's glory. We are ministering the same word, going to the same church, believing the same God, but with different grace. Amen.
Amen.
One of the few is
Amen.
So as we were seated, then this great prophet from Ghana, this was telling me, man of God, there's a lady that I met. That lady in that family, no one is getting married. Yes, her sisters, her cousins, no one is getting married in that family. So I prayed for that person, and the Lord revealed unto me what is happening in that family. Kumbe, in their history, there is a fifth grandmother who was not conceived. Yes, he was striking with barrenness. Yeah, the fifth one in their family lineage. And that woman visited a magician. Yeah, for a magician to help her. Yeah, to conceive a child. And when she did that, that thing really angered God. Yes. Do you know what magician does? Get a mganga. Kumbe that mganga. Alichukua grace ya mtoto akampatia na akatoa grace ya marriage kwa family. Yeah, so that family got very beautiful daughters, very well educated, but no man is moving closer to them. But to the extent, those ladies and that lady are one of them, her cousins, but they don't care about marriage. No, it is not normal. You have to care about marriage. Yeah, but that's a few years. Because it's godly. It's the Lord who said that it is not good for a man to be alone. Come someone somewhere exchanged their grace of marriage with a child in their family tree. Yeah, that's why men are not moving closer to you. Yes, men are not attracted to you. Yet you are beautiful. Yet you have a great personality. But when men look at you, hey, they move closer to you. And what does it matter? Anyway. Yeah, that's why some people are going to curses and yokes. What is happening in our family? Come on, there is someone who has changed your glory with someone. Isn't it? That's why I normally tell people that your beauty, your money, your education, your appearance, yes, will not guarantee you a successful life. Time and chances happens to them all. What matters is Christ in your life. If you have Christ, you have everything. If you lack Christ, you lack everything. That is life, and you can't change that fact. Facts are facts. May someone shout amen.
Amen.
Those amen, do not say my amen in the corner. Amen. May someone shout amen.
Amen.
May someone shout amen.
Amen.
Yes, may shout amen in a Lingala style. Amen. Yeah? One of the So. I'm telling us that there are family issues that are affecting people. That if you are not a man of God who is full of compassion, you start hating and sidelining people. There are people who are being stricken or are being followed by the spirit of rejection. Yes, it's a point that people celebrate you so much, but it is a season, but the same people work and dance against you. Completely, they don't want you. Why? Because someone somewhere in your family visited a magician, because that person was not in a position to get married. Or that person trapped your dad or your mom, yes, with magic, isn't it? So that magic gave that person a love, allowed potions work in that period, as at that time. But what about the coming generation? Yes, you are beautiful. Yes, you are harmless. But when people look unto you, they reject you. These are things that happen. Mzungu alisema shit happens. Isn't it? Yes, and if you not get a man who will separate you from that, Brother Ochuka, Brother Basil, come here. Because Brother Ochuka is shooting the camera. Let me show you an example. Just come very fast because of time. Yes, there is this yoke. Yes, try to walk. There is this yoke that is passing. Hey, come, someone, an athletic man. Sam, the handsome man, Sam Makanani, come here, running. Yes. Sam, the handsome. Yes, come, running, you're athletic, yeah. Yes, look where the pastor is. Yes, walk. Yes, you are walking, but something is attached into your back. If you never get someone with the sword of the word to separate you from this thing, I'm telling you, yes, that thing will haunt you for a lifetime. You may be seated. No matter how prayerful you are, you need someone who will understand you, someone who will move unto you with compassion, to separate you from yokes. That's why I normally tell you people that the spiritual realm is not a respecter of persons. The spiritual realm is not a respecter of your caliber, of your education, of your job, of your appearance, of your connections. Yes, not a respecter of self, because in the spiritual realm, there is nothing like education, there is nothing like currency. Yes, in the spiritual realm, what is there is eternity. And that eternity depends in doom and damnation or in the golden keys and golden gates of hell. So you need someone to separate you from these yokes. You need someone to set you free for you to be at ease and for you to be liberated. Or else you may live a life, a pathetic life. Yes, you are saved, but you are living over because no one is moving closer to you with compassion. Sometimes you have to pray and tell God, you don't need a husband, you don't need a wife, you don't need money, you don't need that job, but you need someone who will understand you. Someone who will move into your life with compassion. Yeah, that's why I don't want to tell people that when you get married or you want to get married to someone, you don't get married to that person because he's rich, because he's beautiful, but you get married to that person because you need him or you need her in your life. Yes, you don't go to church because that church is great, because that pastor is rich, but you go to that church because you need that church in your life. Don't go by sight, but by faith. Am I making sense to someone?
Yes.
Am I making sense to someone?
Yes.
Am I making sense to someone?
Yes.
Yes, I was talking yesterday. Let me finish with this. I was talking yesterday about distressing spirits. Yes, distressing spirits. These are spirits released by God to torment the disobedient people. Sometimes God has another warfare, isn't it? Spiritual warfare. Yes? After that, we pray, after that, God has that. So I was talking about this. Nikasema, you know, sometimes we see dreams and visions. We see animals, we see rats, we see images of people in dreams tormenting us. Yeah? This, we know that these images sometimes can be your parent. Maybe your mom is advised by someone in the village, yeah, to touch or use some magical concoction to make you in Nairobi, because maybe Tony is delaying getting married. This Tony is bewitched. So maybe someone is advising her, hey, for your son to get married, yes, you have to do this and this and this. You have to use the knowledge of Egypt, yeah, so that you may convince that this power may convince that man to marry without a baby. Isn't it? So, and you're a prayerful person. When you pray in Nairobi, you're seeing magic. You're seeing cockroaches coming to haunt you at night. Then you wonder, what is happening? So after that, you declare spiritual warfare. You say, I kill those cockroaches. I kill those rats. I kill those... Little do you know that you're killing your mother? Yeah, your mother is not doing this out of destruction, but out of love and compassion. You want to help this child, isn't it? And when your mother dies, or when your sibling or your relative dies, I'm telling you, you feel the pain. We start begging people, don't give me 2,000, I want to go to the village. So who is a fool? They were saying that my people perish for lack of knowledge. Am I making sense?
Yes.
Don't just keep things at your vision as per your own will, unless the Lord tells you. The people you're supposed to kill are the people who know the truth. The people who know the same truth the way you know it. For example, the person who comes to the same church with you and is reaching you, that person is supposed to die. Those are the people that the Bible says that permit no wish to live. But not about your parents. He's doing this out of compassion. He's doing this out of his own mind because he loves you. That's why my stomach has never been a machine, isn't it? So what are you supposed to do about it? You have to move to that person with compassion and tell God, change that person's heart. Am I making sense?
Yes.
But that person who goes to the same church together, that person who has enjoyed the same revelations the way you have enjoyed, is the person that's supposed to die. Let me make a picture of you when your mom dies today in another person. When I'm watching, I was saying, everybody goes to be with you. You're supposed to be there. You're supposed to be there. You're there. Yeah? Well, there's a person who are praying in our family. That person was used to be rich. Now that person is striking. Yeah? So, kila mungu family, sasa tutatua pesa wa alps. Kila tunata kuomba. Mungu kwa benzi ya kuitendeki. Na mwa benzi ya mungu inatendeka uthidi. So what do you want? My people perish for lack of knowledge. Hakuna mungu kama wewe.
Hakuna kukote.
Eu não sou uma pessoa, eu sou uma pessoa.
Maneba na Colosso, Batrisco, Gonco, Nosso, Beterei. Maneba na Sobotosa, Malasse, Dentro, Malasse, Dentro. Maneba na Colosso, Batrisco, Gonco, Nosso, Beterei. Maneba na Colosso, Batrisco, Gonco, Nosso, Beterei.
People are gossiping you. Yes, people are not understanding. You have to move closer to them with love. But they are responding with hatred. Yes, they don't want you. They want to see you. Ale paloso basse terese de queso bose. Ale bala paloso bosoto rose de queso menese bale se menese. Oh, come on.
Holy Spirit, welcome you to come and pray.
Come and pray.
Come and pray.
humble, have humbled themselves down before you. You say that if my people will humble themselves and call upon my name, you will hear in heaven and send a word and heal their diseases. Jehovah Lord, your people who are in business and their businesses are not doing well because of rejection. Jehovah Lord, I want a testimony that customers are coming back, and to them in Jesus' name. Those who are in work, those who are in institutions of learning, those who are in relationships, Jehovah Lord, you are doing something remarkable in their lives. In Jesus' name, those who are rejected in money, oh Jehovah Lord, you are doing something remarkable now. Yes, yes, Basoto, I can see an angel of God. Yes, with a sword in the heavenly realms. That is just almost coming down to liberate these people. Oh, Lepa, no, seven, 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 seven. Lepa, last of all, we count 1, 2, 3, and you shout Jesus. 1, 2, 3, and you shout Jesus. Yes, but also, but seven, seven, seven. Make sure that you shout in the top of your voice. But the Spirit is telling me there's some people who are standing behind, but they are passing through rejection. They are passing through neglect to the extent of suffering in their hearts. But out of pride, they are standing there. Yes, please, don't miss this anointing. This anointing is special and is coming to you today. If you feel like you're the one, don't stand. Just kneel down. Come and kneel down in the dance. And believe that the Lord is doing something in your life today. If you think that you are rejected, if you think that money is not coming your way, if you think that you are suffering from inferiority complex, yes, you are despising yourself because you are thinking people don't like you, people don't appreciate you. Come! We are not kidding! It is not a joke. The need of God is here! And the Lord wants to liberate you. Oh, remember, pride comes before a fall. I'm giving you half a minute. Ole Paloso, come and join these people here in the world. Ale Paloso, Basete, Rese, Bekese, Belese, Bete. Ole Balaso, Basete, Rese, Bekese, Boso. Ale Paloso, Basete, Rese, Bekese, Boso. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you are great, I worship you, you do. Ole Pase, Beto, Rose, Bekese, Belese, Bete, Rese. Okay, okay. And in the mighty name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And in the mighty name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I want to release the anointing of freedom and liberty in these people's lives. I want to release the spirit of liberty in these people's lives. 1, 2, 3.
Jesus!
Oh, in the mighty name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I'm releasing the spirit of liberty and freedom out of these people's lives in the mighty name of Jesus. 1, 2, 3.
Jesus!
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 Last time! 1, 2, 3. May you receive your honor.
Amen.
May you receive your freedom.
Amen.
May you receive your being.
Amen.
May you receive your connection.
Amen.
May you receive order.
Amen.
Oh, the Lord who listens, the Lord who have watched over you, have visited you remarkably in Jesus' name. And it's not by might or strength, but by the power of the Holy Ghost. I pray and seal. You may stand and cloud before the Lord as you are going back to your sleep, sir. And then Paloso Masete Rese. Under his
power. There is power. Power mighty in the blood.
deliverance in your blood. Shine upon you and be gracious unto you.
Amen.
May the Lord connect you to people who will move unto you with compassion.
Amen.
And may you receive peace.
Amen.